beauty from the inside out. I'm going to walk and talk. Dermatologist and author of The Beauty of Dirty Skin, Dr. Whitney Bowe, is here. And she says getting healthy skin is not just what you put on it. It's about what you put in your body. So this is fascinating stuff. We can treat ourselves inside out.
We sure can. So, right. So basically, collagen is what keeps our skin looking firm and plump and smooth. And you can think of collagen like ropes of protein in the skin. Now, when we're young, those ropes are nice and tight, right? Mm-hmm. But when we age, the ends get a little frayed, it gets a little loose, and that shows up as wrinkles and sagging in the skin. Basically, our bodies can't repair the collagen as fast as we're breaking it down. So I tell my patients, ideally, you want to eat a well-balanced diet. Try to get some high-quality sources of protein in your diet to give your body those building blocks that it needs to repair the collagen. There's one small study showing that collagen supplements might help to boost some of that, restore that elasticity.
Okay,
in the skin.
So collagen supplements are not regulated by the FDA.
They are not.
So what do you recommend patients look for when they look to add collagen in their diet?
So if you want to look for a fish source, on the label it's going to say either fish or marine collagen peptides. Ideally you want that fish to be wild caught to keep things like antibiotics low. But you can also get your collagen from cows, and that's going to be called bovine collagen.
Right.
That you want it to be grass-fed or pasture-raised,
I've
ideally.
I've actually used both, and I put them in my coffee.
Fantastic. So yeah, you can either put it in a coffee, or I like to add it to a smoothie, especially one that has things like blueberries and spinach, because these are rich in vitamin C, and your body requires vitamin C to make collagen in the first place.
Okay. And so they work hand-in-hand together? It's
you
more
need
powerful
them both.
To put them all in
Absolutely.
One
Absolutely. Your body
soup?
Can't use the collagen peptides unless you also have the vitamin C.
Okay. And then there's something called I don't know if I'm going to be able to say this right, adaptogen?
Adaptogen.
Ah,
so adaptogens,
I'm learning a new word,
are plants and herbs. They've been used in ancient Chinese and Ayurvedic medicine, and some people believe that they can help your body to cope with stress. So stress, we know, triggers your body to produce a hormone called cortisol.
Right.
I know the jury's out, but I believe that cortisol interferes with your collagen, so ideally you want to dial those down. Again, not FDA regulated, but there are some, like ashwagandha, that you can taste a little bit of my ashwagandha matcha latte here.
Okay.
It's got a bit of a bitter flavor to it. So I like to put it in either a turmeric or a matcha latte, something that, you know, is not going to give you that bitterness to it. It comes in pills and liquids and powder, but, you know, it's interesting. It's got some animal and plant studies showing it can actually decrease cortisol levels.
That's incredible. And you can, and turmeric you mentioned as well. I put that in my eggs. Talk about what that can do for the body.
I love turmeric. It's got great anti-inflammatory properties. And when we can dial down inflammation, it's just good for our overall health.
All right. This is all great information. Dr. Whitney Bowe,
thanks
as always.
Thank you.